Hello and welcome back. So in today's session, we are going to see about the key objectives of the process of talent management and what are the various stages involved in talent management. And we will also see and analyze the stages of to be followed, like recruitment, selection, human resources planning and retention. And we will see what is the difference between talent management and knowledge management. And we will be also seeing the consequences of failure in if we don't manage talent. So this is the key objective of today's session. So let us get into the process of talent management. So when we talk about talent management, the most important thing that we need to look forward is the optimal workforce required in the organization. When I talk about optimal workforce, we need to understand what is the kind of workforce we require, which means whether we have the right number of people in the organization and what kind of qualities do we look forward in these employees. So when we are talking about planning, HR planning is mainly about identifying the right number of people and what are the qualities that we require and for what work are they going to contribute or what are the key roles for which we need to hire. So this is the most important thing that we need to know about HR planning. So when we are planning, the things which we need to see is what is the business strategy that we are going to adopt. So what is the vision of the organization and what is the mission of the organization. When we talk about the vision and the mission of the organization, we should know about what do we see 5 years or 10 years from now, what kind of products we would like to put forward to the customers and what kind of products are we going to develop. So if we are going to bring in those products, what is the kind of manpower requirement we will have and how are we going to acquire those manpower. So that is understanding the business strategy, and the business strategy will decide on how many employees do we require and in what duration we will be requiring them. So when we are clear about the strategy and the progression of how we need these employees, that is when we will decide on how and when we are going to start the hiring process. So the HR should be in a position to understand the business first and foremost before they get into the task of hiring. Now, when the HR is aware about the requirements of the business, that is when they will identify the right places through which they can hire. Now, when we talk about talent, we need to understand that these are the key players, and in order to get these key players on board, we should get the hiring done in the right manner. That means we should be able to identify who are these players and how we are going to attract them to our organization. So, understanding the business, which means that we should be able to identify in from which field are we going to attract these employees. Because say for example, we are looking for a position of CFO. So the CFO in an organization plays a major role in the finance planning and all the other major decisions relating to the finance of or the funding of the organization. So when we are looking into hiring this position, who are we going to look forward for? Where are we going to identify these players? Because the most important thing that one needs to understand is the high performers do not go in for look of job change every now and then. They are mostly in believers of performing and they keep performing in the current role wherever they are. So it is important that we reach out to these people or these potential employees. So, in order to do that, first and foremost thing is we need to identify which are the key areas or the organizations from where we can attract these employees. So, when we talk about CFO position, we should be thinking about similar kind of organization. The first and foremost thing is we should not look in for the same competitors company's CFO. We should not be looking forward to pull in employee from another organization who are our direct competitors. So, then who is next in a line? So, what we need to do is we should identify similar kind of business areas through which we can get this this position. So, this task is also done by various consultancy companies. So, majorly if we see that for higher rank positions or for the top management position, we have hiring consultancy companies which are able to understand and identify these key performers for the organization. How do they do this? They have a clear research team who are in a position to keep a database of such people, and they are in the front to take the task in through the organization. So, the HR of the company doesn't have to do the task of calling in these people, but they can hire a consultancy company in order to attract these potential employees. So, that is where it is important to understand the business and also the business strategy. Then we should be in a position to understand and measure the evaluation of the workforce. So, if we are in a we have a clear cut definition of the performance appraisal, that is when we are able to identify what are the key competencies we are looking for in a potential employee and how do we identify them. Because if the key competencies are known, that is when we can look for those competencies in the people whom we are going to attract. So, that becomes very, very crucial to identify the performance areas and to measure them in the right manner. Now, when will this be useful? This will be useful when we are doing the interview process. We will know what is the benchmark we are looking for and is the potential employee able to match up to that benchmark. When we will do the interview, we will ask these kind of questions and we will be in a position to identify if this person has got those potentials or not. And also, we should have a clear cut workforce plan. When we talk about the workforce plan, we need to identify, as I said, the kind of numbers we are looking for, how many openings are there and how many people we need to hire. This is when we need to identify whether we are going for bulk hiring or are we going for individual hiring. When I talk about bulk hiring, which means if say for example, we are identifying that there is a big order or a big task that is coming ahead, like we have bagged a big say for example, a project, then in that case if we require more number of employees, then we will have to go for bulk hiring. So, if we say talk about a company which is in the field of say for example, we are talking about employees of a IT organization where they have a big project in hand and they are going to deliver that in the next 6 months or a year's time. So, they will be requiring additional developers or maybe they will be requiring additional software engineers. So, here they will have to look for bulk hiring and they will have to identify the key places through which they can do a bulk hiring. So, they will have to list down those colleges or institutions or the places through which they can do a bulk hiring. So, that is where it is important that we should know a clear cut plan about the workforce and we should know about the number of people that we are going to hire. So, let's go to the next point. So, how are we going to attract these employees? We will be able to attract the employees only when we have a clear cut idea about what is that we are looking for. Who are we going to? It is like a marketing where we need to know which segment are we focusing on. Who is our target audience or who is our target customers? Similarly, in HR, we should have a clear idea about who are we looking for and how should we attract them to apply in our organization. So, that is where branding of the organization comes in picture. Every organization has to have a brand image in the eyes of potential employees. Now, when I say brand image, I mean to say the organization may be doing good, but are they able to get the right people to apply for the jobs? Are the employees also looking forward to work in that organization? That is an important question that needs to be answered here. So, marketing or branding the organization amongst the potential employee plays a major role in attracting the right candidates to apply for the key positions in an organization. Say for example, if an organization has bagged one of the best employers award, then more number of employees will be looking forward to apply in those organization and take up a position in that company. So, it becomes very important that a brand image needs to be created. And who creates these brands? The brand image is created by your existing employees. So, if you are keeping your employees engaged and they are able to identify value for themselves in their organization, that is when he will or she will propagate this to the outside world, and that is when a brand image of being a good employer will come in light, and that is when the potential employees will be applying for the positions. And the next stage in attracting is talent acquisition. See, hiring and talent acquisition are two different things. I mean, recruitment and talent acquisition are two different things, and we need to identify what is the difference between these two. So, in the upcoming slide, we will be talking about what is the difference between talent acquisition and recruitment, and are we going to employ a freelancer or a consultant, or we will be doing the hiring by our own self. That is also an important decision that we need to take while doing the attracting. So, how are we going to develop the employees and what are the stages that we will look forward in that? We will talk about that in detail in the upcoming slides. So, let us quickly go for the next slide. So, this we had discussed already, what is HR planning. So, we will just sum up in totality. So, the three key areas to be taken care in HR planning is understanding the organization's business strategy and evaluating and the measurement of the analytics and also developing the workforce plan. So, these are the three major areas we need to look forward in HR planning for talent management. And next is, as I said, what is attracting and how we are going to have a employee value proposition for the potential employees. How are we going to do the marketing and what is the way in which we are going to attract potential employees to apply for the position? How are we doing the talent acquisition? Are we going to hire a consultant or a freelancer for doing the hiring process? So, these are the key things that we need to decide well in advance before we go for the next stage, that is the next stage. So, let us quickly see what is the difference between recruitment and talent acquisition. So, the recruitment is a short term process, whereas talent acquisition is a long term process. So, in talent acquisition, we are talking about the acquisition or hiring of the key players or the potential employers who are going to be our top management or maybe the middle level managers in the organization, and these will be the people who will be contributing towards the strategic development of the organization. So here it is a long term process when it comes to talent acquisition. Then comes recruitment is a subset of talent acquisition. So talent acquisition is a bigger picture, whereas recruitment is a subset of talent management and talent acquisition, and the one is ongoing cycle, whereas the other one is a linear process. When I talk about an ongoing cycle, we should be able to keep on identifying the key performance criteria of the organization, and we should be able to identify how we are going to sustain these key performers in our organization. So it is an ongoing process. We need to keep identifying the key performers and try and retain them in the organization. Now, when we talk about recruitment specialist and talent acquisition specialist, there are two different things. When we talk about talent acquisition specialists, they think from a broader perspective and they think from a strategic point of view. Here they are more concerned about getting the right people to apply for the job, because here they will be taking only those options who are already doing well in their current job roles. So the mindset of a talent acquisition specialist is totally different from a recruitment specialist who is looking into filling the current job openings and looking into the day-to-day requirements of the organization. However, a talent acquisition specialist is a person who will look into the strategic plans of the organization and identify the key players who are going to be playing an important role towards the development of the organization and hire for that position. So that is the difference there. And strategic talent acquisition is finding the right candidates for the future position. So here it is very important to understand that the future positions where the organization is willing to see themselves 5 years from now, and what is the kind of business opportunity we are looking for, are we able to attract those type of people. Say for example, a small or a medium level organization is looking forward to attract customers which are larger players in the market. So here the marketing team may not be, the current marketing team may not be in a position to cater to the requirements of the future, because they may not be in a position to go and get orders from these larger organizations. So now the organization has to think about hiring potential market marketing specialists or managers, brand managers who can seek and get orders from these larger corporations. So that becomes the investment that needs to be done amongst the people who are going to be our future key players. For them, we need to identify the position now, and we should start attracting these players for the tomorrow. And it again is the talent acquisition is again industry specific or company specific. Again, as we spoke earlier, for innovative products, it becomes very important that we are able to attract the right talent at the right time, because any product which any corporation which is involved in innovative products, they need to keep themselves ahead of their competition. So it becomes very crucial for them to attract the right employees into their organization. Here we can quote companies like Apple. If we say they are into industry which is totally technology driven, so here attracting the right talent becomes very important for the growth of the organization and also for launching new products for the future requirements. So how are we going to develop? So development is the next important stage in talent management, and development involves first stage is onboarding. As we spoke in our previous session, onboarding is just not the process of getting the newly hired employee to come on board, but it is also making the person comfortable and becoming, making them more productive immediately after they have joined the organization. And this happens only when the line manager are able to understand the requirement and make it a comfortable working space for the employee who has newly been hired. Because the possibilities of an employee to leave the organization in the first 6 months are higher when compared to a tenured employee. The reason for that is a high performer always is vulnerable, and if he doesn't find himself comfortable in the existing workplace, it is possible for him to go ahead and look for another job opportunity. So that is where onboarding is very, very crucial in the initial days for the new hire. And performance appraisal and management. Once we have hired a highly talented employee, it becomes crucial for the organization to keep a clear and a transparent performance appraisal system in place, because unless and otherwise a performing employee does not get recognized or his talent is not being showcased, it is not possible for them to survive or sustain in the organization. Because if the organization feels that they are not able to promote the right candidate, that is when an organization fails to meet the requirement of the developing requirements of the organization. If the employee who has got the talent does not get promoted or is not put into the right place, that is when the organization fails in executing the development. And learning and development also plays a very crucial role, because as the organization's requirement keeps changing, it becomes crucial for the employees to get enhanced, and they should be learning the right skills and competencies that are required for the future development of the organization. And capabilities framework. So every organization has got a clear cut detail of what are the key competencies required and what are the capabilities that are required to perform a particular task. So that framework needs to be clear, and the employee should be helped and assisted in developing those competencies. That is when the development of the organization will take place. There should be clear cut pathways defined for an employee. He should be knowing as to when and how he will be developing in the organization, and he should have a clear cut career path ahead of him in order for him to survive or sustain in the organization. So that is important, that organization should have a clear cut pathways drafted for every employee. So you know that today if a person is in level 3, what and how he will be getting promoted and how he will be getting into the higher level. So band, when we talk about organization where they follow a band method, then the organization should have a clear plan as to what are the various levels at which the employee needs to work in order to improve on his brand. So that is a clear cut plan that is required in an organization. So how do we develop the culture of retaining the potential employees in the organization? When an organization finds that he is a key performer, it becomes equally important. Now the role of the organization is more towards retaining this employee, because if the culture of retention is not there, the organization will end up spending a lot of money in training the new hires, and it will also be an added cost to the organization. Because if we are not able to retain the trained employees or the tenured employees, then every time we will have to go through this same process of training the new hires and help them onboarding and do the entire process time and again. So how do we develop the culture of retaining? Now here the important task is that how are we keeping the employees engaged? How are we seeing that the committed employees are going to be with us for a longer duration. So, we should understand how the product is has got features. Similarly, positions have got key features. We should understand the requirement of an employee and see that we are able to cater those things. So, that is when it becomes important that we should think in line with the employee's requirement and develop a healthy culture of retaining the employees in the organization. We should have a clear cut remuneration strategy as to when and how, what kind of hike should be given to an employee, how are we going to give the employee a level of satisfaction that he does not have to look forward to another organization just for the want of money he or she is expecting, or the kind of hike that they are expecting in their current career. So, this is something which the HR manager should be able to focus on, and he or she should be able to develop a right remuneration strategy for the existing tenured employees in the organization, because that is when the more likely that the employee will try to switch. So, let us quickly see how the transition happens in an organization. The organization should have a clear cut succession planning. What is the importance of succession planning in an organization? Say for example, an organization which is like a bank or a financial organization, and one fine morning it is a news that the CFO has moved out of that organization and there is no next person in line to fill up that gap. What do you think will be the impact of this on the stakeholders or the share market of this particular company? It will have a clear and high impact on this. What is the reason for that? Say for example, XYZ bank has no CEO today. The stakeholders will have a clear mindset that this organization did not plan for the position and there is no successor in line. This will give a bad image about the organization, and it will take years and years for them to get out of this situation going forward, because two things will happen. One, the position will be vacant for a longer duration and that will cause a turmoil in the organization, and two, once a new person is hired, then it will take some time for the other the new CEO to take charge of the organization and put them back into track and start performing. So, that is when succession planning is very, very important. And we talk about succession planning, I am not only talking about the key players like the CEOs, but also for every level of organization there should be succession planning that should be there. There should be internal mobility, retirement, knowledge management and exit interviews. These are also very important in handling the transition of the key players in the organization. So, what are the causes for poor talent management? The reason, if we are not able to maintain our talent in the organization, that is when they will leave the organization and look for better prospects. So, long working hours can be one of the reason, unsupportive management, lack of coordination and communication, higher personal aspiration and unsatisfactory monetary and non-monetary rewards. These are the reasons why talent management can go wrong in an organization. If they are not able to maintain their existing talented employee, they will switch into another company. And what are the consequences and what are the failures if the talent management does not happen? There will be poor morale among the employees, there will be tension in the organization, there will be lack of learning, there will be a risk of aversion, and monetary rewards may not be there, and there will be a decline in the productivity. It will increase the turnover of the organization, and there will be a poor industrial relations, and also there will be inability to accept change. So, if talent management is not in place, the organization will face all these problems, and that will become a reason for the slow downfall of the organization. So, when the organization is at its peak performance, that is when they should be aware that they should start doing the talent management and see what is their long term goals and try and retain the organization. So, that is the ideas that we had seen today in the session, and hope you enjoyed and had a lot of learning from this session. Thank you.